Man, I am glad to just be out of that. I'm so glad it's over. I mean, maybe shouldn't have let Heath and those kids run on ahead, but I think it'll be fine. I mean, it's not really... But, what? Oh, it's you guys again. Just hanging out. Are you guys stuck in there? Oh, maybe you all need to be let out. I mean, I don't know if this is like your aquatic prison, but regardless, stay back. Stay back. Look, I don't know if you guys committed some kind of raccoon or water-based crime, but I'm gonna let you guys out, or at least maybe you're stuck. I don't know. Looks like you want to get out, so I'm gonna help you. You crafty creatures, you. So enjoy it, maybe. That way you won't be- Oh god, he's out. He's out, I'm running. I don't want to know. Maybe it's fine, I'm not taking a chance. Just be okay, it's fine, Castor. Oh, there's Heath, but... We're back at the Warren, pretty much, but... Where are the kids? Heath? Where are those dumb kids we rescued? Do you know? Hmm? The kids? I don't know. They ran on ahead, and I really didn't feel like keeping track of them anymore. They kept asking me questions, running around everywhere. It's, just exhausting. So I let them run on. Not really sure where they went, though. But whatever, they aren't bothering me, so I'm fine with it. Wait, what? What? You, after I worked hard to save those kids, you're just letting them run off? That's what's going on? Relax, man. I've checked. We're not being followed, and we're close enough to the Warren now. I'm pretty sure they're just gonna go and find Bernadette. Man, those kids love her. Especially Nathan. And Rick. Or Susa something? I should really learn the other kids' names. I think one of them's Vernick? I don't know. I just started to name them things like Orphan Girl, or Orphan 2. I still don't remember what happened to Orphan 1. They were my favorite. Anyway, Castor, what's up with that woman back in the mansion? It didn't really seem like she liked you all that much, but why did she help us? I know what you're thinking, Heath, but maybe she really does like me, like a lot. Probably likes me. Or, well, maybe she just felt like it then. Oh, so you just don't trust me, Heath, is that it? But we're lucky that she was there. I mean, I'm not sure what we were gonna do otherwise. I mean, sure, we could have caused a ruckus, but I don't think we would have gotten out of there with all those orphans in tow. Yeah, we really did get lucky. Probably lucky. Anyway, thanks for your help with all of this. I wouldn't have been able to pull this off without you. But somehow we were able to pull it off. Now everything's fine. The kids are safe, and even better, Bernadette did not find out. Great. Yeah, that's good and all, but are you going to tell me what you traded those kids for in the first place? What was that? No, like, what did you want from those cultists, man? Like, what were kids for? Oh, yeah, that thing. That's a good question. I'll tell you about it later. We should probably just get back to town, though. Oh, man, you're blocking me like this. Sorry, look, I'll tell you about it later. But don't worry, I don't think it'll kill anyone. So we should be fine. Good? It won't. Definitely won't kill anyone. I'm not worried now. Definitely not. Everything should be fine. It's good. But here we are back at the Warren, finally. That's, thank goodness for that. And got to change my clothes back to my awesome, regular, amazing Castor clothes. I mean, I'm probably gonna keep that robe. It was a pretty amazing robe. Real nice. But, you know, we should really think about maybe getting a bridge or something for this. I don't think there's any easy way to get around like, you have to go beyond those hills over there. This is a really isolated place. It's just weird. Well, we'll just... All right. Go on through. This is gonna be fine. Oh, hello, duck. Think you're so much better than me? hanging out, floating around. Well, I'm sorry, I can't float as well as you can. Or fly, for that matter. I don't need you... Hey, you be quiet, all right? Don't judge me. I'm doing the best I can. I don't see... What have you done today, Duck? Hmm? I saved some orphans from a bunch of crazy cultists. What did you do that was so great? Hmm, Duck? Swim around in your moat? Oh, is this a moat? Duck, is this a moat? I think this is a moat. That would explain a couple of things, like why there's no bridge. I would appreciate a bridge, though.
I mean, who builds an entrance and then doesn't have a bridge? What kind of monsters are these people? It's just inconvenient. Oh, there's Bernadette. Oh, here you all are. Where have you been? Bernie. We just got back from our field trip with Teacher Heath.
It was really great.
Field trip? It was nice, but not very educational. You be quiet, Nathan. The girl with the shovel was my favorite. Shovel? Guys, no, maybe stop. No way, the fire and explosions were cooler. Stop talking, guy. Fire? Explosions? What are you children talking about? Hey, Bernadette, don't. It's cool, it's fine. Don't worry about any of it. Oh, hi, Castor. There you are. Did you see Heath and the others are back? I was starting to get worried, too. But it turns out I was worrying over nothing. Although, I am a little worried about what they're saying. Do you know anything about this girl with a shovel or these explosions?
Those kids are on drugs, Bernadette. They're on drugs. Don't listen to them.
Okay. If you say so. I'm just glad the kids are back, but I just wish Heath would tell me. He does this all the time. Taking them on random surprise field trips, I'd spend less time worrying if he just gave me more notice. Oh well, I guess this is better than the time he took them to them treasure hunting for the Turtle Fang's graveyard. That's a thing? Apparently, I've never even heard of it. He originally told me he was taking them on a nature walk. I wouldn't have found out about it if it weren't for Nathan. Oh, Nathan. Do you know anything about their trip?
I have to go now.
Oh, sure, yeah. That sounds serious. Anyway, thanks for helping me find the kids, and feel free to stop by the orphanage anytime. The kids always love it when someone stops by.
We have an orphanage?
Yes. It is a house for orphans. Anyway, thanks again. Oh yeah, Bernadette, that is not a problem. I am glad I could totally help. Please don't ask me any more questions about that. Everything's cool and good.
Kids never tell her anything.
Especially you, Nathan. I'm watching you, Nathan. Definitely. Definitely watching you.
Good. You guys are about still. Well, that's good. Have you seen... Wait a sec. This seems like it's really come along. I don't remember doing a lot of this work. Wow. This is amazing. So, Mayor, what do you think?
Oh, Castor, you've done a great job on these houses.
Hmm? Well, we'll probably need to build a couple more, but this is a good start.
I know, Mayor. I'm so great.
Oh, don't be so modest, Castor, but this is looking good.
I know. I just can't be stopped.
Seriously, Castor, cut it out. Nobody likes that.
Oh, okay. I gotcha.
Fine.
But we're making progress here. Things have really changed around here since you arrived. Our town's nearly twice the size now. And yeah, we still have a lot of other problems, but at least it feels like we're making progress. I was starting to get a little frustrated. And once we're done here, we've got so many other projects to get started. That is not what I would know. I had to save cultists from kitten. I was rescuing orphans.
So much work. Why are you giving me more work?
Okay, Quint. How are you dealing with this? Good? Is this up to your standard? Ah, it's some fine work you've done here, lad. Yeah, thanks. You're welcome. I don't know, actually, what you mean. Well, now that it looks like we're finally settled, how about we have a barbecue?
I thought Ingrid said you weren't allowed to have any barbecues. Man, I thought that was a thing.
Yeah, but what Ingrid doesn't know won't hurt her. It'll just be a small one.
That doesn't sound like a good idea to me. Really, man.
All right, fine. If you don't want to help, I won't force, but if you show up to the party, you better bring a couple of trees with you.
Wait, trees?
It's just not a queue without a couple of bonfires going.
Bonfires? That seems like a lot. But, I mean, yeah, fine. If I'm
going out and I'm coming to this barbecue, which I guess you're having anyway, I'm trying to stay out of it, but I'll bring trees if I come. It seems like a nice thing. Oh, before I forget, Ray was asking about you. Did you run into her yet?
No, not yet. I mean, I just got here. Do you happen to know where she is, though, man?
Well, last I saw her, she was at the new barn.
Wait, there's a barn? What did you...
It's over behind Winnie and Ray's place. You can't miss it. It's that barn-shaped thing.
Oh, yeah, that makes some sense. Thanks for the heads up, guys. I'll go check that out then.
What the? Is this?
We have a barn now? I'm still surprised at all these other houses, though. Oh, there's Winnie. Man, this is awesome. I don't remember us planning this house, though.
Barn, whatever you want to call it.
I mean, this is nice, but what do you do?
Well, if it isn't my good friend Castor. Long time no see.
Oh. Hi, Toby. I'm fine.
What are you doing here?
Oh, well, I had some free time, and I got to talking to Betty here. Do you know she was a farmer back at Watership? That's really impressive. The soil around Watership is tough, and even good farmers have a hard time yielding a crop out there. So she must be really good.
Is this a farming lesson, man? Is it?
No. I was just talking to Betty, and she mentioned that she was looking forward to farming out here in the Warren, so I figured I'd build a barn to help her out.
So you're saying you built this barn? Like, on your own, you built this?
Well, yeah.
And just 'cause you had some free time? Like, that's a thing?
I'm pretty good with a hammer.
All right, man. That's ridiculous. That's too nice. I gotta go.
Okay, well, I'll see you later, but I'm gonna hang out here a little bit longer.
Oh, wait, yeah, actually, have you seen Ray at all, by any chance?
Oh, one of the other villagers from Watership? The one with the blue sweater and the wavy blonde hair?
Don't most of the girls from there have... Wait, they all do have blonde hair, don't they? Don't most of them do?
Haven't seen her. But you should check with Betty. She probably knows. I mean, she and Ray were practically neighbors at Watership.
Yeah, I was gonna talk to Betty anyway.
Toby.
Okay.
Jeez.
Well, neat. Anyway, talk to you later, Castor.
Yeah, Toby. I'll talk to you later also. When you're not being nice about everything and building freaking barns in your... A whole barn!
This door opens not the way I want. Oh, hey, Betty. You're such a jerk. Such jerk, Toby. God. Hey, Betty. Betty, hi. Look, great barn. Really like it. It's fantastic barn you've got here.
Yeah, it's real nice, isn't it? I just mentioned to Toby that I was itching to get farming again, and then he started raising this barn all on his lonesome. I'd have helped, but... I wanted to see if he could really do it. Besides, no sense in both of us getting hurt.
Have you seen Ronbald when he builds houses? It's a straight miracle no one's died yet. But this Toby feller seems to know a thing or two. Yeah, fine, but I was told Ray was looking for me. Have you seen Ray at all?
Ray?
Yeah, she was here, but I think she went back to her place. Have you tried there?
Maybe I have tried there.
Well, maybe start there.
All right.
Maybe I will, Betty.
That's a good idea, actually. I didn't think to do that. It's cool. I see you now are ignoring me, and that's fine. I'll just go
and find Ray, although the sun's going down. You know, I may just go back to my place and talk to Ray in the morning. Toby, you can stay here if you want, but it's getting dark and someone's gotta protect this town. Lord knows it's not gonna be me. It's my turn to sleep. That's what I got planned. Definitely earned a good night's sleep, so I'm gonna take it.